Special education is funded through a combination of local, state, and federal funding. The exact amount the United States spends on special education is unknown, but is roughly $31.8 billion. The special education population is expected to grow, which means more funding will be needed. More disability categories are being discovered, and that means the scale of special education eligibility is expanding. These statistics and informational statements are researched and proven in the 1970s and have grown to larger numbers today. Special education has always been a controversial topic and is consistently studied throughout the United States and the education system. I work with special education students in fifth grade and also get to experience things firsthand. Ms. Adam McGraw also taught me about IEPs and the importance of them. In the article, Why the Feds Are Short on Funding, author Evie Blad writes, school funding issues are a major problem with direct links to student achievement levels. Schools with smaller budgets can't offer smaller classes, often can't offer smaller classes and better programs, which result in lower student achievement, creating a lack of quality in the education they are trying to provide. Throughout my speech, I will cover the benefits of continuing to fund and how giving more funds can positively impact the special education program and the students within it. I will also touch base on how the special education program can go into a downward spiral if funding stopped. In my audience analysis, there was an equal split on if we should continue to fund special education. 39% said we should fund more, 30% said keep it the same, and 30% said we should stop the funding. First, I will talk about the money currently being spent on special education programs throughout the school districts. Every school district will set different limits for each program in their school. Each state will have a different vision on how they want to fund their education programs, specifically special education student programs. Some states choose to get reimbursing for a percentage of students who use special education resources. Some fund specific systems and teachers to teach special education, and some have fixed grant amounts for each student. And some do a weighted system in which special education students generate a fixed multiple of the general pupil allocation to about two times as much. From Chamber's article, Financing Special Education, Chamber writes, the special education population is expected to grow because more people are growing up in poverty with low birth weight, substance abuse, diseases, and HIV, which means more funding will be needed. 32 states are currently considering major changes in how they fund their special education programs and the people who educate them. To put this into perspective, on average, the cost per student is roughly $16,000 if the student does not require additional programs or services. A special education student costs approximately $30,000 higher than the average student. Most states' government recognize the need to adapt to accommodate for the different types of disabilities and make broad categories in order to best benefit the students who receive these special education services and their classroom time. In 1973, there was a study done that identified five different alternative programs. Regular classes aided by specialists, regular classes with a resource, special class, special day school, and residential school. Those are like the different alternative programs. There's ones that are like one-on-one time, and then there's ones that are really like smaller classes. Like in the middle school, there's the special education classes that I'm a part of are like that I go to. Are like four to eight students in each classroom, and then there's like me and the teacher, and then usually there's another parent in there just kind of trying to make sure there's one-on-one time. And then there's the regular class with resources, so they have different like activities and hands-on things for them to use. In our school district, we spend a lot of money on our special education programs, around $2 million. From the 2020 Litchfield School District financial statement, the U.S. Department of Education gives grants to the schools that fund Title I and Title II programs. They also fund different programs throughout every grade level. They give special education grants to preschools that amount to around $18,000. They also give approximately $90,000 to the state grant accounts. Across the nation, total spending on regular, special, and other special education services amounts to about $78.3 billion, with about $50 billion additional for the special education services. This may seem like a lot of money, and to the average person it is, but when it comes to special funding, with about 500 plus students receiving special education services, it is a minimal amount. The budget may seem like just a bunch of random and large numbers, but if some of those decrease, the school system would collapse. You may think the funding for special education stopped or decreased, but it would only hurt or impact those who receive the services. Budget cuts also come from being understaffed, like any other job. Students are deemed eligible for services, the school may be understaffed to meet the needs of all those students. For example, a building may need two speech language therapists to fulfill the needs of its special ed students. Therefore, if there are not enough funds being given to pay the speech therapist, some of the extracurricular activities you enjoy may be cut or get less funding because the school board will most likely deem a quality education to be more important than an extracurricular activity. It can also interfere with your learning and your teachers. Although everyone may not agree with everything the budget is spent on, for example, flexible seating or sensory toys, they can be beneficial for the most part. So flexible seating, you may have seen it, but it's just a bunch of different like chairs. There's like wobble chairs, bean bags, just round cylinder stool type things. And then they just have a bunch of different colors, kind of like just brightens up the room, and they all have a little bit different purpose. And sensory toys are just kind of like fidgets that they can use too. Flexible seating, they can be beneficial for the most part. I personally do not think flexible seating is necessary, but there is a lot of research done behind it. Flexible seating allows them to wobble, rock, bounce, lean, or stand, which increases oxygen flow to the brain, blood flow, and core strength. It also keeps young minds more alert and more focused. Even though special education programs have been underfunded for many years, we cannot continue to just have enough funds to get by. Over one-third of our students in the school receive special education services. Therefore, if we don't support funding the programs, they will not be able to receive the adequate or quality education that they deserve. Like any other situation or topic, there are benefits and downfalls. You have already heard the negative effects of decreasing funding, so let's talk about the positives. There are many positive outcomes of providing adolescents with special services while they receive an education. Children learn at their own pace and style within a nurturing and learning environment, and they also can interact socially. This factor is very important for those children with disabilities for the reason that this factor could help them rebuild their self-esteem and self-confidence to themselves. Students also get more assistance and personalized time and schedules provided by their teachers. Special education students are put into smaller classes and oftentimes have their own paraprofessional assigned to them to encourage and teach them additionally from a teacher. They also have a more specific plan of action for their daily lives and are most commonly following a routine that helps them to retain information better and helps them focus and learn because of the repetition they follow. Throughout my speech, I have covered the benefits of continuing to fund and how giving more funds can positively impact the special education program and the students in it. I also touched base on how the special education program go into a downward spiral if funding is stopped. All around us, there are people who may not even realize they are being impacted by the funds that's given to the special education programs. If you are not directly receiving the funds or the services, you are still being impacted by the funds. How the funds fluctuate. Please continue to research and educate yourself on where the money is being spent and how it is impacting your education. Once you're old enough to make those types of monetary decisions, please keep in mind that you were able to receive a quality education because of people who believed in you and your peers, and that your peers deserved a quality education, special or not. Thank you for listening.